Author of this work. I'm from the Real Research Group, and this is a collaboration with the PhD student from the Instituto de Investigación y Desarrollo Educativo at Ensenada in Mexico, and a collaboration with the Tecnológico de Monterrey through the Research Group in Innovation and Education, coordinated by Maria Soledad Ramirez Montoya. This is the index, my work. And first, this is a work focused on describe the analysis of participant navigation logs in massive online courses. In this case, we analyze the navigation logs in the Educational Innovation with Open Resources course developed by the Tecnológico de Monterrey on September 2014. This course is supported by Coursera platform. There were 14,000 students enrolled in the course, and finally, more or less 5,000 students finished the course. And this is part of a big work, a thesis work, about development skills to mobilize open educational resources in MOOC format. And this is a small part of the analysis developed in this thesis. This is the part of the this study uses a MISET methodology, and this is a part of the quantitative results. And later there are another part in other words related to the qualitative results. First, we follow a methodology named Vela, and this is a methodology to analyze learning data in massive context. And the model provides a framework to develop analysis. First, we have a phase to transport the data. Later, in parallel, we work with the data to analyze the information and develop several visualizations. And finally, we get the results, we get the knowledge obtained from the data, and we come back to the transformation phase. Okay, first phase are the data preprocessing. This is the part that I develop. This is a file provided by Coursera platform, the clip stream log. This file contains all the clicks that the users of the course done inside the course. Any click in the forums, any click in the video, all information about the time to see the video, go forward, go back, are in this log. The problem is that this log is in a format, JSON format, and it's not easy for a person that is not don't have computer skills analyze the data. So, in this sense, we process the file following three cycles. First, we analyze the different variables, and we deleted some variables with information that is not relevant to analyze the navigation. For example, the client, the user IP, and the user agent. We don't need information from the computer user to see the course. Later, we transport the log in a database based in MySQL, And we save the data into tables with the different variables. This table is the most important because it have all the important variables related to the clicks. And this table has all information related to videos. In this study, we didn't use the video information because we only focused on the navigation. And the third cycle is get derivative variables from these variables. Mm-hmm. And for do that, we develop a tool that you can give anonymous user identifier provided by Coursera, and you get all the derived variables. For example, you can get a file with all variables, and each row is a user, and each column is a variable. The most important could be the time that the user is connected to the course. And this is very difficult to calculate because you only need the time when a user click on a resources inside the course. So we apply an algorithm to calculate this time. Moreover, we get a variable about the sessions inside the course. Because Coursera didn't provide when the user connected to the course. So you only can get this session variable through estimating when the user leave the course. If you have a click at 6 o'clock and the next click is at 11 o'clock, it's a new session. Okay. In this sense, this information is provided to other research to analyze and get information that the Coursera don't provide in the statistical model that provided the Coursera platform. And in this sense, we can see that there are more or less to 200,000 clicks in all the course. And this part is not my part, so it's difficult to me to explain the statistical information. So, and one of the most important things are the clicks decrement through the weeks. There are a course of 4 weeks, and the last week there are less clicks. And what about each week? In our analysis of the data, we get clicks per week. So we can analyze where are the most clicked resources in each week. And this is the data getting from the analysis, more or less. There are 60,000 clicks during the first week. If you see the last week, there are the half, 36,000 clicks. Moreover, there are different resources inside a MOOC, videos. There are a curious characteristic of this course, that is, there are videos developed by experts, short videos with different experts collaborating in the MOOC. And there are discussion forums, peer review evaluations, self-assessment evaluation, and other kind of resources such as search page, content page. In the case of the navigation paths, we have to work more in the visualization of this information to get a complete view of the all paths through the whole course, but it's difficult. And now we can conclude that the most interaction inside the course is from the forums to the peer evaluations, and the both peer evaluation to discussion forums, and the self-assessment to the peer evaluations. And finally, because I don't have time, the conclusion are that the analysis of the navigation log provide important information, but all information provided say that it's not important how many clicks do the user, the participant of the course. This is a problem due to the research divided the different participants regarding to the qualification. Non-superated the course, superated the course, and with excellence. And this variable is not important to difference how the participant interact with the course. And finally, in this sense, we have detected a problem to analyze the navigation logs in MOOCs because there are more or less 200,000 clicks in the navigation log and represent all the information is very different. So, thank you very much.